49 states and the District of Columbia require drivers and passengers to wear 3.5 shoulder seatbelts. Only California and Texas, however, require drivers and passengers to wear 3-point safety belts in school buses. Colorado recently tried to pass a bill that would have made it the state law to wear seatbelts when riding on a school bus. But the bill failed in committee because it found it too expensive to get seatbelts on school buses. The school seemed to think that the buses are safe without seatbelts, even though they have had children injured and some even died because of seatbelts in school buses. A video on safeprogram.com shows when a school bus tips to one side, jeopardizes the safety of the kids on the bus. Let's take a look at this video.
Oh my God.
As you can see, that it's not safe without seatbelts on school buses.
How it is not necessary to wear seatbelts on the school buses for the passengers. There is a state law in Maine and everywhere else that states that anyone under the age of 18 must wear seatbelts. However, school buses do not provide seatbelts to be worn. Therefore, it's breaking the law. But we are here to prove that it is not necessary to wear seatbelts. Our three reasons state that they are dangerous, a hassle, and they interfere school budgets.
Safety is the number one reason there should be seatbelts on school buses. 7-year-old Sarah Frank died in her father's arms after being ejected from the window when the school bus she was riding collided with a pickup truck. The crash occurred about a mile from the Frank home in Warden, a small town near Billings, when its driver failed to yield at a stop sign and the pickup broadsided it. A friend of Randy Frank's saw the crash on his way home from work and called Randy and suggested that he should arrive to the scene immediately. When I got there, I saw a bunch of kids standing around, but Sarah was lying on the highway and nobody was with her. He said in a voice as he began to crack. With sadness. She just kept telling me how cold she was. I asked her to hold on, but she couldn't do it. She died in my arms. To explain kinetics, which is the scientific reason why seatbelts were ever put in cars in the first place. Say a school bus is traveling at 50 miles per hour and hits a tree. While the bus is no longer in motion, you're still traveling at 50 miles per hour, which means that you hit that crudely padded seat at 50 miles per hour. And once you're no longer in motion, your suspended organs, such as your brain and your heart, are still traveling at 50 miles per hour. The purpose of seatbelts is to prevent any physical damage to occur from becoming a projectile and makes the internal damage less significant. Children's bones and organs are still developing, and if a child goes headfirst into a seat at 50 miles per hour, serious developmental disabilities can occur to the child forever.
Our first argument is that wearing seatbelts can be very dangerous. Most crashes result in injury, not death. Kids might survive the crash but end up dying as they are stuck in their seatbelts. What if the bus is burning and the fire? The bus driver doesn't have enough time to get back. So seatbelts could easily get stuck. A quote from www.localschooldirectory.com. A bus driver cannot help all students escape if they are belted and the bus is sinking in a lake or a body of water. Kids could be hanged by their seatbelts if the bus rolls around. Just imagine sitting in your seatbelt, waiting for the bus driver to come help you. But if there's a fire, it might not happen. And the bus drivers really aren't heroes. A fire spreads really quickly. They won't have enough time. And seatbelts could also,
Why couldn't the children not buckle their own seatbelts?
Well, in a lot of cases, the bus could be dented, and they might, if they're hanging upside down, they might not be able to get their seatbelt open. And they can also be used as weapons, like bullies. They could easily use seatbelts to choke other kids just to annoy them, and it could become a huge problem. That's all.
Okay. Behaviors are something. Behavior is something else that can be affected by the installation of seatbelts on school buses. If kids are buckled into seatbelts, they will be less likely to move around on the bus. If they are not moving around, they will not be tempted to do more mischief. My nephew is five years of age, and he has to buckle his seatbelt when he is here in America. But when he goes to India, we do not require us to wear a seatbelt, and he does every mischievous thing he can in the car. He will stick his head out the window, touch every button in the car. He even jumps from seat to seat, which can be dangerous. Not nowadays. According to Mary Ann Albert, author of The Pros and Cons of Seatbelts in School Buses, seatbelts prevent students from being thrown out of their seats if the bus is involved in a crash, and it improves behavior in school buses. As you see here, you can see a bus that has no seatbelts on it, and you can see how the kids are talking and how their feet are in the middle of the aisle. On the other picture, you can see the kids are seatbelts and sitting next to their friends and talking and being happy and safe.
Sorry to interrupt, but most high school kids will probably just ignore the seatbelts because they're old enough, and I can probably tell most people on my bus, most of the older kids, would just ignore.